Hi, I'm Lori Spielman, first selectman for the town of Ellington. Just got reelected again. I want to thank all the people who came out to vote. We never get enough people to come out and vote. It's very important. And also, we have our annual report if anybody would like one. We tried to give them out at the polls, but if you couldn't make it, we also have them at the Senior Center and the library, also at Town Hall. So feel free to come by and pick one up at any time at all three places. Also, I have a special guest today that I'm very excited is Kevin Bartlett. Welcome. And Kevin is from Park and Rec, so we'll be talking to him in a few minutes. But also, I just wanted to wish everybody a happy Thanksgiving and happy holidays coming up. Also, now we're coming up into our winter season. December 2nd, we are having our Winterfest. And that is going to be, like I said, December 2nd. Look for different things on our website. The Hall Memorial Library does things the day before, the day of the event. And also at 3:45 on the town green, we are having our Christmas tree lighting ceremony. We have a chorus out. We have a lot of different things at Nellie McKnight's. They have a nice fire going. They have hot chocolate. There's many things to do in the center of town, which is great. After that, Santa Claus comes, and then we have our big fireman's parade, the lighting parade, which is great. So, Kevin, how's it going? How long have you been at Park and Rec?
Absolutely. Well, thank you for having me, Lori. I've been working for the Parks and Rec Department a little over 2 years now, but I was with the Parks and Rec for a number of years prior as a summer day camp counselor. I was a youth basketball coach for them as well. And it's just a great opportunity to work for the town of Ellington, where I was born and raised, and then working for the Parks and Rec Department with Mary and a great group of people. So
now, when I first took office, there was Bob Tedford, who's been there forever, and also Mary. So what is your staff like now, and how's everything work?
Absolutely. So right now we have Dustin Huguenin, who's our Parks and Recreation Director. Dustin's been a tremendous mentor to me, and I believe he's a tremendous asset to the town. Mary Bartley is still working for the Parks and Rec Department. She's our Assistant Recreation Director. Myself as the Recreation Coordinator. We also have Tina Mazaluski, who is our Admin Secretary, and we are bringing a new staff member on board relatively shortly, so we're very excited for that as well.
That's great. So you've got quite a bit. You have more people, but what people don't really realize is your programs, you offer more programs in Ellington than I think surrounding towns. Am I wrong?
Absolutely. Yeah. So in Ellington, we're very unique. We carry a number of our youth sports programs. So we do the entire soccer program, basketball program. We recently picked up lacrosse in recent years. So the Ellington Lacrosse Association has come back under our umbrella. So the lacrosse program is something that we now cover, as well as we do all the instructional sports for t-ball. We do a variety of day camp offerings. So we're now offering a teen day camp program. We also have our Little Knights program, which is for like the 3 to 5 year old age group. That's in addition to our typical, we call it the Summer Knights program. So we're very excited for all of the offerings that we have. We also have our Sandy Beach up at Crystal Lake. So we do cover a variety of things, and hopefully we provide all of our residents, and that's in addition to a number of adult programs as well. We have pickleball, basketball, all sorts of things. So we try to cover the whole gamut, per se.
Now we're lucky, and I don't think it's open yet, but finally we've gotten the Jacob Poulin ice rink, but it's not ice rink.
That's right, yeah, so it's a deck hockey rink. We're very excited. Hopefully that project will be done this coming spring. As soon as that's available, we hope to start some programming at the new deck hockey rink. The Poulin Foundation has been tremendous in their donation to the town. So we're very excited to start that.
So explain the difference between ice hockey and that, deck hockey.
Absolutely. So ice hockey, you would traditionally be on skates. It's a little slippery. For me, it's a lot more difficult to play ice hockey versus a deck hockey rink. You can play on rollerblades or you can do it standing up with shoes on. And they're very similar in the sense that they both have goals. I know the Poulin Foundation has been a tremendous asset in terms of getting community members to step forward and kind of help us out and get this project started. So it's something that we're excited for, and I know a lot of our residents are as well.
Do any of our surrounding towns have anything like that?
Not that I'm aware of. I know there are ice hockey rinks at a number of the surrounding towns. I know Enfield has one, but deck hockey in our area, I believe, is relatively unique.
Yeah, Waterbury had a few, but that's a ways to go. But to have it in Ellington is a pretty nice asset for us.
Absolutely.
So what are you doing right now? Not the second, but...
Absolutely. So right now, our primary focus is on the upcoming basketball season. We have a number of volunteer coaches who work with us on a seasonal basis. Tremendous volunteer group. We have the rec basketball evaluations that will get started on Saturday, December 2nd. So that's when the majority of our basketball players will come in and we'll get them evaluated and placed on teams for the winter. We have our instructional basketball will get started on December 9th, and then our high school basketball players will get started shortly thereafter. So we have a big season coming up. There's a little, just about 500 basketball players total throughout the program. So it's a heavily involved program throughout the town, and we utilize all five of the Ellington Public Schools. So
now, how long does that go for?
So that program will go traditionally until the beginning of March. So we're in the schools starting the beginning of December through March, and our travel teams are actually already practicing, so they had evaluations for them in October.
Now, don't you also do volleyball during the winter?
We do, yeah. So we have an adult volleyball program that's running throughout the entire school year. So they pretty much go until April. And then we as well have pickleball. We have an adult basketball program that runs on Monday nights. So we're utilizing the schools as much as possible, trying to give a lot of the Ellington residents an opportunity to play. And ultimately, that's our main goal.
That's great. Now, do you charge? You must have to charge because you have shirts and all these different things, right, for basketball.
Yeah, so there is a cost. We try to keep costs as low as possible for all of our sports. But for basketball, we do pay for all of our custodial costs, as well as the cost of the shirts, the referees and scorekeepers that we hire. One of the main things that we pride ourselves on is we give a lot of job opportunities to some of our high school students, college students, some of our local residents. So we like to see as many of them involved as possible in whatever capacity they may be, as a volunteer coach or as an official. So that's something we really appreciate, and we like to see them out there on the courts.
Boy, that's great. That's the more we can keep people involved and doing something like that, I think it's great. So also on the way over here, we were talking about your working on a overall plan. Can you tell us a little bit about that?
Absolutely. So this plan is a master plan for the Sandy Beach up at Crystal Lake, as well as Robert Tedford Memorial Park, kind of analyzing what we have for field space, potentially making plans for the future additions to the park. That way we, as an entire town, have a plan moving forward and we can go out and seek funding and try to push on some of those changes that we want to make. Sandy Beach in particular, it needs a lot of work. We're looking to add some sort of shade structures in the future, as well as some other additions that we hope to make.
Yeah, I want to have some kind of a shade structure up for next summer because, you know, with the sun and being so, we don't have any shade there now. The trees had to be cut down from disease, so plus they were dropping limbs and everything else, but we will somehow get shade up there for the people who want a little break from the sun. I think it's important.
Absolutely.
So I think to have an overall plan, it's a lot of work and everything, but like you said, you could pick away at, you know, if a new field is needed over here, you can concentrate on that. You know how it's going to fit into the existing park.
Exactly.
That's huge. So moving on to that, from what goes on into the spring.
Yeah, so our spring is extremely busy. We do have spring soccer, which gets started. We also have our lacrosse program that's now under our umbrella. So we'll have spring soccer, lacrosse. I run an instructional t-ball program that goes throughout the spring. So the spring gets extremely busy. We're also leading into our summer programming offerings. So throughout the spring, while soccer, lacrosse, everything's going on, we're really hiring for our summer program. So we're getting into the day camps. We're getting into the sandy beach, because as soon as they're ready to go, we try to get a jump start on those.
And at Sandy Beach, you know, we're very lucky to have this great beach. I know Public Works gets it all cleaned up and started for the, put the buoys out and everything else. You have swimming lessons?
So traditionally in the past, we have had swimming lessons. Unfortunately, due to the low number of water safety instructors, we haven't been able to offer that the last summer. It's something that we're definitely exploring coming back in the future, as long as that's something that the state can kind of help provide and we can get people in and train to properly provide that instruction. It's something that we always love to provide the Ellington residents. So,
yeah. How about sailing lessons and things like that? I know we have a sailboat that's a nice couple donated. How does that work?
Yeah, so I do know that there's the Crystal Lake Association has utilized sailboats, and previously it's not something that we've run a program for, but it's always something if we have a qualified sail instructor, and they're more than welcome to come forward, and we would look into offering a program like that for the summer months.
Yeah, I know we talked about also at some point maybe a kayak rental or things like that, just to kind of give you know, a little older people or teenagers, something a little bit different to do, a little more fun, and instead of just swimming and sitting on the beach.
So, very true.
Yeah. So with that, through the summer, your camps are great. Yep. You do a lot of different things at the camps. All different ages, right, I presume?
Correct, yeah. We have from starting at as early as 3 years old through middle school, we provide camp offerings now.
And do you have lunch at these camps or?
We do, yeah. So lunch is provided at both our Little Nights and Summer Nights day camps. It's something that we started with the COVID pandemic. We were very fortunate in order to partner with the Ellington Public School System. And they're a tremendous resource for us. All of their school cafeteria workers are the most kind individuals that you'll interact with on a daily basis. So we're very fortunate to have that opportunity to provide lunch. I know it's something that a lot of other towns aren't able to provide. And I know it helps quite a few of our families in town.
I know some of the camps, when the older kids, don't they get to go on trips and everything? These trips look pretty good.
They do, yeah. So they'll travel throughout the whole state of Connecticut. We've sent them to Mystic Aquarium. They'll go to baseball games, the Basketball Hall of Fame up in Springfield. We try every single year to come up with unique trip offerings for them, just so they're getting a new experience, and it's something that's exciting and might appeal to them.
Oh, yeah, that's great. So just a couple things that are going on in town. Our Public Works Department has extended the sidewalk on Abbott Road, which is in front of Windermere School. I don't know if you've seen that. And we've had a few people that were interested in having that sidewalk for safety. There's a lot of condos right there. So we're adding on to that sidewalk. It should be done probably by the end of the week, depends on the rain that's coming. The cement's pretty much all done. I have some pictures. And also they'll back it up with topsoil and seed it, but nothing will probably come up until next year. Also, to let everybody know, the farmer's market is now at Ellington High School on Saturdays, basically 9 to 12. Come check it out. There's still fresh produce, carrots, turnips, and things like that. They have a wide variety of different vendors coming in for Christmas. Have you been there? It's really something to see. And we still have the seafood. From Stonington Seafood is up there, which is great, especially for the holidays. They have the best shrimp. Also, to let people know, the Strawberry Bridge, which the town's been working on with the state for a long time, we had a grant for this. And it's finally open, done and open. So the Strawberry Bridge is located off of Route 83, obviously on Strawberry Road. And if you're coming from Hoffman Road or Egypt Road, it's off of Blueberry onto Strawberry. So that bridge is nice and wide. We've got pictures. It's open. It's almost completed. They have some things they have to do in the spring to finish that up. But that's going to be, it's beautiful. We were there yesterday doing a ribbon cutting, and it worked out good. So back to Park and Rec. So you've got a lot of exciting things coming up. Do you work with the Trails Committee at all, a little bit?
We do, yeah. We're very fortunate throughout the town, I would say, with working with a lot of great community members, Trails Committee being one of them. Trails is very much a part of our office. They come in, we have regular conversations, and Trails, I would say, is a great asset to the town. They provide us our site maps for the trails throughout, and I know a lot of our residents like going out on the trails and exploring on any given day that they may have. So,
and these Trails Committee people are just so great, because we're one of the few towns that have started putting emergency markings on the trail. And it's, if you get a trail map, they're on there. So if you're using the trail map and you sprain your ankle or get hurt, you could call 911 and say, I am on this trail and this is where I'm at. So our 911 people are very aware of this. They have the maps also, so they can pinpoint and send rescue people right to that spot instead of trying to go up and down the trail looking for people. I think that's great.
Absolutely.
So basketball is cranking up. Also, with your team that you have working every day, you also have the Park and Rec Committee.
Correct, yeah. So we have a Parks and Recreation Commission, which is made up of 9 community members, many of whom have been throughout our entire program offerings. So Gordy Oliver is our commission chairperson. He's a tremendous resource to the town, heavily involved. I know his grandson worked for us for day camp this past year. He's been working for us for a couple of years now. So it's great to have community members that are heavily involved in the Recreation Commission.
So I was on a liaison for a few years. Explain what they do. They meet once a month or Correct. More. I don't know.
Yeah, so they definitely meet once a month, sometimes more, depending on what sorts of programs are going on then, or if you have to call a special meeting of some sort. They're also a great resource when we need to call them and suggest any changes that we may be looking at, or to ask them to be a part of basketball evaluations or something of that capacity. The Recreation Commission has been heavily involved in terms of being volunteer coaches over the years, serving as volunteers for different events we may have, whether it may be a road race or one of our sports seasons, or finding community members who might be good fits for camp counselors or lifeguards. So they've definitely been a big help.
That's one committee that I think has probably the longest committee members on it. Some of those people have been there for quite a while.
They've Absolutely.
Donated a lot of their time and experience and everything. I think it's wonderful. So somehow we got to recognize them for all their time and effort they put in. Explain to me about the road race you just had.
Yeah, so we had the Robert Tedford Memorial Road Race that happened recently. It's in memory of our longtime recreation director, Robert Tedford. I believe he was the recreation director for Ellington for 43 years. And we have an annual road race now that occurs at the beginning of November, where a lot of community members come out. We'll have a 5K that starts at Robert Tedford Memorial Park and also ends coming into the entrance of the park. A lot of people get excited for this road race. It's very much in honor of Robert Tedford, who used to be my basketball coach in middle school. So it's a great opportunity to come out, celebrate an individual who was provided a lot to the town in general, and it's all in his memory. So it's something that we get close to 100 runners every single year. And
yeah, I was going to ask you how many people ran That's quite a few.
That is, yeah. So this past year, we had close to 100 runners. We were very fortunate because the beginning of November isn't always the most reliable weather-wise. So we were very fortunate with good weather this year. We had close to 100 runners, and it was a tremendous event. So
we've had so many Saturdays that were rainy, and the farmer's market had quite a time. But yeah, I think it's a great, you just lucked out because it was raining before, right?
Yeah, absolutely. We got lucky this year.
Now, do you do any other races during the year?
We traditionally don't. I know the Ellington Triathlon is something that has happened previously. If there's enough interest in the town, it's something that we would like to bring back.
But that was pretty good. That got a lot of activity.
Yes. Yep.
Boy, that's really great to have all these different programs, and it's a lot of work for you guys in planning and everything else. Even like the 5K, you got to work with the ambulance, the police, the fire department, shutting roads off. I mean, all sorts of different things.
Yeah, it's a lot of work, but at the end of the day, the enjoyment that we see from the residents' faces and when everybody comes out and is having a great Saturday morning together, I think it definitely makes it all worth it in the end.
So the only thing we're lacking is disc golf. We're working on it though, right? Trying to get disc golf somewhere.
Absolutely. Yeah, yep. It would be nice to find a home for disc golf.
Yeah, that's one thing that a lot of towns have that we don't have, but we're gonna get it somehow. So what else do you have going on?
We have a variety of sports programs. If anybody's interested in being a volunteer coach for this winter's basketball program, feel free to reach out to our department. If you're interested in working as a basketball referee, feel free to reach out, or a scorekeeper as well. We're always looking for community members that are interested in being involved in youth sports and helping us run the programs for every single one of our residents. It's something that we pride ourselves on, the product that we put out. And a big part of that is the volunteer coaches, the book and clock workers, the referees that are really there every single Saturday, Friday nights, working long hours, working these basketball games. And that's a tremendous, tremendous help to us, and then asset to the community as a whole.
Now, did you get involved in the Trail of Treats or Trunk of Trail of Treats or whatever? How do you say it?
Trail of Treats. Yep. So I was there. I was not involved in terms of tabling for that event, but we were a part of the Trail of Treats and got a chance. I think it's a great community event that is put on. I believe that the Lions Club put that on. And yeah, I think it's a great, the kids get extremely excited. I hear about it all the time for instructional soccer that they have Trail of Treats coming up that week. So it's a great event.
And what I always want to say and thank our in-town businesses so much for helping out in a lot of different things. I know they sponsor all different games and things like that, but also the Trail of Treats, they really come together and dress up and hand out candy. They have all different booths represented, restaurants, Ellington Agway. Everybody comes out, and it's a really great time. It was great weather, too. We lucked out on that again.
We did.
So, but Ellington businesses, I think it's so important that we support them. We have our local business bingo contest coming up. Support your local businesses. You can look more on our website about that. We have bingo cards, and what you do is go to these local businesses and get a stamp and fill out your bingo card and see who wins. They have prizes. And that is basically from our planning and zoning department is heading that up. So just trying to keep everybody interacted with different businesses. We have the best restaurant in state of Connecticut, Trattoria,
yep,
which is in back of Hidden Still. And they've got many awards. They do a fantastic job. It's wonderful food. Jay Rigo's, Casey's, of course, Luann's. We can't forget Luann's. And also, we have a Starbucks coming to town pretty soon. It's right next to McDonald's. Chuckwagon, everybody goes to the Chuckwagon for breakfast at least. It's quick, it's great food. But a lot of people, you know, they travel out of town to go out to eat. We have everything right here, pretty much. But support our local businesses, whether they're landscape, construction, fertilizer business, Homestead Fuel. Like I said, Ellington Agway, we have so many great people. And what I want to do too is wish you and your family and everybody that is watching a happy Thanksgiving. It's a great family time to be together. You don't have to worry about work. A lot of, I think Facebook, there's a lot of places that are closed. There's a whole list of, I think Big Y's closed. They basically shut down so people can spend time with their families. So I want to thank you so much for joining me. And everybody out there, happy Thanksgiving. Thank you.